Assalamu alaikum. My name is Hasham. My lesson name is Haircut. When he was a little boy, people who met him for the first time marveled at his name. It was a long name and a bit of a tongue twister. When he started school, his teacher preferred to put him down in the class register as D and P. All his friends called him D and P. His mother, who had been responsible for giving him the name in the first place, shortened it even further and addressed him as D N. And his sister, not to outdone, called him D. Now that he was older and wiser, DNP or DN or D always introduced himself to others by his full name, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. He also threw at people others by his full name, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. He also threw that people would think more highly of him if he drew a fine brush. So he did. And it was a very fine brush indeed. It was a marvelous brush, as the ears went by Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, smart, impressive. Brush turned very grey. It was still a magnificent sight. But when he started to grow his hair long, he began to look like a tramp. One hot day, as he walking the road to the market to buy some vegetables for his lunch, he suddenly felt a little weary. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada took off his cap and wished with his handkerchief before replacing it carefully on his head. The cap used to fit perfectly well until he started to grow his hair long. Fortunately for Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, he was passing by a park at this time and spot an empty bench beside the outer fence of the park. So he sat down to rest for a few minutes. As he sat in the scorching sun, wondering how he was going to carry those vegetables home, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada decided to close his eyes for a movement or two. In precisely 30 seconds, he had dozed off. He had dropped forward till his breath. Chin rest on his chest and his cap fell into the lap. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada snored. Half an hour later, a barking dog woke him from his nap. He sat upright with a jerk. It took him a few seconds to remember where he was, where he had come from, or where was going, and he had noted his cap in a lap. Much to amazement, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada's cap had a few coins in it. "Where did these come from?" he asked himself, looking to be mugged. As he sat examining the coins, a passerby stopped and added another coin to his collection. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada was greatly shocked. My goodness, he explained, people are giving me money because they think I am a tramp. He hastily removed the coin from the cap, placed it on his head, stood up, and brushed his jacket. Yes, it's all looking a little crumpled, he threw to himself, and perhaps it's time for a new look. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, I am going to remand to you. With his decided mate, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada moved along towards the market with great speed. At the market, he did not go to vegetable stalls. He marched straight into Sami style salon. Through Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, as he entered the salon and looked around the place. Can't spell, but I hope they can cut hair. There were 5 chairs in front on 5 long mirrors on the facing wall. 4 of the chairs were taken and the 4 gentlemen occupying these chairs were having their hair cut. The room felt like an oven. By Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada was determined to stay. The owner was a large man with at least 3 chains. There was not a single chair on his head. He greeted Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada with a bow. Hello, said the owner. Nodding his shiny head from side to side, haircut, trim, shampoo, washing, bread all. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, wondering if the man knew any 2-word sentences. As he threw about this, he looked at himself in one of the long mirrors on the wall. It was not pretty sight. Yes, replied the Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. Shampoo, washing, no hair, cutting, trim, bread, yes. Sitting, please, said the man, pointing to an empty chair. Us, said Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada to himself as he sat down. 2 words in correct grammar, but 2 words in one sentence. I hope he can do better with my chair. Mr. Sami, the owner of Sami Style Salon, wrapped a sheet round the neck of Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. The sheet covered his chest and arms and reached almost to the floor. It was a little grubby, but Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada did not mind. He had made up his mind. Mr. Sami introduced one of the assistant barbers. The young assistant scurried forward, crying a comb in the hand and clicking a sharp pair of scissors in the other. He smiled as he approached and nodded his head from side to side, just like his boss. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada did not say a word. He started at his reflection in the mirror, while the barber clicked away at the stop of his head. Beads of sweat began to drip from Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada's nose. He had been hot outside the salon. He was hotter inside the oven-like room. And to make matters worse, Mr. Sami and tucked him up in a blanket. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada began to nod. Not like Mr. Sami or his assistant had done, but a sleepy nod, varied every time his chin fell forward on his chest. The barber yanked it upright, but this did not worry Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. He was too hot a fright to weather. He soon fell soundly asleep. Soundly is the right word for this kind of sleep, because Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada made an awful sound. He snored loudly. Half an hour later, Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada eyes opened sleepily. He yanked a string and then remembered where he was. He looked at himself in the mirror. He started again. The reflection in the mirror was not one he recognized. It was not Danish Nasiruddin, but some other man. He raised one arm and winked, just to make sure that the man in the mirror was himself. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada leapt out of his chair and screamed. He pointed at the man in the mirror and then turned to face Mr. Sami, who was hiring towards him. "What have you done?" cried Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada. Where is it? I asked you to trim my bread, not shave it off." "Bread shaving," replied Mr. Sami, using a rare two-word sentence again, the nodding his head from side to side. "Okay." "There is nothing okay about it," cried Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada, stroking his smooth chin. A long argument flowed. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada insisted on paying less because Mr. Sami had not followed introduction. He complained that he had come into the salon as Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada and was leaving as somebody else. Mr. Sami wanted more money because more hair had been removed from the customer head. Finally, after a long debate, a very happy Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada left the salon. He forgot all about his vegetable and headed towards the bus stand. He mumbles, grumbles, and orders all the way there. Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada joined the queue and waited for his bus. Then an old lady, who was also waiting for the bus, turned to him and spoke. "Young man," said the old lady pleasantly, "I left my watch at home. Will you kindly tell me the time?" Curtly, said Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada with a smile. "It's time to celebrate." The old lady gave Danish Nasiruddin Pirzada a very odd look. But he did not care. Young man, he repeated to himself as he left the cook and trudged home still smelling.